Hi there folks, and welcome back. Yes, Malta part 2 video is on its way. I'm just trying to work out the best medium to record it on, yeah, so that we don't have a live stream that breaks down whilst we're actually making a video. Once I've worked out the best way to go about doing it, I'll bring the video, yeah? Anyway, excuse me. As you can see from the title of today's video, I'm going to be touching on the topic of, was I right to walk from my MCC? For breaking their own rules. Now, I get messages all the time from people on this platform here on YouTube, also over on Facebook, yeah, and it seems to me a lot of these people that are putting these new front patch MCC type clubs together, yeah, there's certain things they're actually missing before they even start on the journey, yeah, of creating their club and getting it sanctioned, everything. Now, I go on and on and on and on and on about rules, yeah, bylaws, rules, club constitution, all this type of stuff, yeah. There's a reason I go on about all this stuff, because it helps to prevent the very topic I'm about to talk about if you've actually got a proper, solid, established set of rules within your club. Yeah, and this is why it's important that your club has a set of rules laid down, yeah. When you very first start the club, it's one of the very, very, very first things you should think about doing is laying out a set of rules, yeah, that everybody has to abide by, regardless of whether they're just a member or whether they're an officer. You must have a set of base rules for your club. Otherwise, you end up with situations like this. Now, I didn't want to know any information about said club. I told the guy before we start talking, I want you to go to your Facebook page. I want you to hide everything to do with the club that we're going to be talking about. I didn't want to know the name of the club. I still don't know the name of the club, and I don't want to know the name of the club, especially after this type of behaviour. So he joined this club around 2 years ago, and he went through all the prospecting and everything that he had to do. Yeah, he even, yeah, had to, you know, get off the L plates and everything before he could prospect for this club. But, you know, he had to work to get into this club to be able to start to prospect. And then he prospected for this club for how many months it was. Yeah. And then he noticed something this past Christmas just gone. And this happened without the actual rest of the club being notified or even spoken to about what the officers were about to do in the club. What they did was, they first, and, it is, and let me just give you a little bit of a background on this, right? Another club had opened up in the area, yeah? And this club was already like two or three times the size of this older club, yeah? And this older club has started to panic. So what they've done is, amongst the officers, they've decided that girlfriends and wives can now wear a full patch. No prospecting, don't even need a bike or any of that. Well, this set him off. And of course, the officers then explained to the club, well, we've got to do this. We've been put into a position. We've got to do this because this new club's going to get bigger and all this sort of stuff. As if that really matters. Yeah, so of course, you know, he swallowed it. I wouldn't have swallowed it. I wouldn't. I would have been gone at that moment, because as soon as you get to that kind of mindset in a club, it's time to walk. Anyway, he let it slide, yeah. And then, without the club being notified again, the officers brought somebody else into the club. No bike, no license, no nothing. Oh, and they made him a full patch member because they've done so many great things for the club. Yeah, still haven't got a fucking bike though, and they're flying MCC. Yeah, and that rubs people like me up the wrong way. I started out in an MCC. So now you've got somebody in the club, yeah, that hasn't even got a bike, hasn't got a license, no intentions of getting one from what I can gather, yeah, and they're walking around with a full patch on, the same as all these girlfriends and stuff. Again, he let it roll. I would have been gone the first time. I wouldn't have tolerated it even the first time. So this week, or should I say last week, yeah, the club, again, the officers, on their own, brought in another person into the club that doesn't have a bike. They have a license, but they don't have a bike. Yeah? And they brought him into the club as a full patch member. And of course, this person's got even more annoyed. It, by now he's just ripped his colours, his patches off of his waistcoat, slammed them on the table and walked away. So he asked me if he was right to do that. Well, I'll be perfectly honest with you, I would have been gone as soon as they started all that crap with the wives and girlfriends. Yeah, because at the end of the day, yeah, in a club it's not about numbers, right? You people need to understand this. This is not about numbers, okay? And as one of my good friends, a guy called Tricky, pointed out to on one of my posts I put on my Facebook about this, he would rather ride with six brothers, yeah, than 20 civilians, people that he doesn't know much about or even know. Yeah, and I'm of the same thinking on this. And if you're going to do these, start these new clubs and start calling yourself an MCC, yeah, you need to make sure, yeah, that you have a set of rules laid down, written rules, yeah. And I would suggest that the first rule that you put on the list is, yeah, no one can join this club without a motorcycle and a motorcycle license. The next one I would put on there is that the officers alone, yeah, cannot bring people into the club without a full club vote. Yeah, I mean, this is why you have rules. You lay this stuff out before you even start. You have to protect the club from this kind of behaviour. Yeah, because at the end of the day, it's not about quantity. It's about the quality of the people that you have riding with you, partying with you, hanging out with you. You need to know that you can depend on those people. Yeah, you can't depend on these other people. They ain't even got a flipping bike or even a license. Yeah, they're not going to be the ones riding by the side of you, looking out for you and all this. They don't even deserve to be wearing a patch. And any club that flies MCC and just throws out patches like this, yeah, as far as I'm concerned, not an MCC, all right? Not an MCC. Social group is what I would call them. So as far as I'm concerned, yes, the guy did exactly the right thing. I would have walked the first moment that they started bringing in wives and girlfriends without bikes, without licenses, purely to make up the numbers. This isn't about numbers. Yeah, if you're going to be in a motorcycle club and you're going to put a motorcycle club together, it's better to have six real good type brothers around you than it is to have 50 people that you know fuck all about. Anyway, that's my take on that. You all stay safe. The Malta video will be coming next, and I will catch you all another day, another way. And remember, you folks out there starting these freaking clubs, yeah? Make sure you set out a proper set of rules. There's plenty of websites out there where you can get a template from. Bye now.